Tonight, a special edition of Evening Magazine. It's your chance to tickle your touch tone and pick the stories you want to see this evening on Evening Magazine's Phone Show.
Will it be sun, sand, and suntans with this summer's hottest wetwear?
Or choose to meet the man who shot Marilyn Monroe before she went blonde?
And who was Ted Bundy's first victim? Some think he started killing at age 15.
It's your choice, and it's your chance to decide from these stories and more tonight on Evening Magazine's Phone Show.
I can hear those phones ringing already, Jan. You're calling up to vote for what you want to see on our show tonight. Thanks for joining us on another special edition of our show. I'm Richard Hart.
And I'm Jan Yanehiro. Tonight, you tell us what you want to see in Evening Magazine. You choose the stories. All you have to do is pick up your phone and call 863-5555 on your touchtone phones.
Here's how it works. We're going to give you several times during the evening three choices of what you want to see. You decide what you want, pick up the phone, and press the button. That's in the 415 area. But before you pick that phone up, here are your first three choices.
People are seeing strange things in the woods of Pennsylvania. Are these 10-foot monstrous masses animals or creatures from outer space? To join in the search for Bigfoot, choose A. Then, take a look at the wetware that could caress your curves and heat up the beaches from Maui to Malibu if you choose B. And when this little girl vanished in the summer of 61, police had no reason to suspect the family's 15-year-old paper boy. He turned out to be the notorious murderer Ted Bundy. Was Anne Marie Burr his first victim? Choose C.
There you have it, your first three choices on tonight's Evening Magazine Phone Show.
Now, last Friday in our phone show, a lot of you called to complain to us that you tried to call our phone show and the lines were busy. Well, could you try us again tonight, please?
Try, because we both have tried, and we've proven that you can get through if you're persistent, all right? You know what you want, just dial, and when we return in just a moment, we'll tell you how you voted. Time to put your phones down. You have had plenty of time to vote. As a matter of fact, people have been voting since 9 o'clock this morning because we've taken the whole day to find out what you want on our show. And as we turn around and look at the all-electronic Evening Magazine tally board, we
see the winning story. Nobody voted for C? Look at this.
Looks like no contest.
Oh, there we go. There we C, okay. All right. B is the winner.
Yeah.
All right. You really didn't want to see all those swimsuits. You really wanted to see the beach of Maui, right? Ocean Pacific is the name of the company, and this is what you'll be wearing on the beach this summer.
Yeah, and watch carefully because you don't want to miss the Midnight Iguana.
The pioneer of surf and beach wear is Ocean Pacific. Since it was started 15 years ago by a couple of surfers, OP has grown to become the second largest junior swimwear manufacturer in the U.S. And the beaches of Maui have never looked so good. The swimwear designer for OP is Jeannie Tronic. It's Jeannie's creativity that sets surf and beachwear trends. And this year, the look is both athletic and ladylike.
This year, the influence is very feminine, and it's really split off into two directions, which is kind of exciting. There's a direction that's very streamlined, and that's sleek and kind of sexy, and body contouring. And then there's also a very feminine direction, which is draping, ruffling, shearing, you know, all the pretty kinds of things that women love to wear.
To grab ideas for her new designs, Jeannie cruises the world's bitchinest beaches. The latest Ocean Pacific theme is naturally beaches around the world. What a job! Having a slow day, out of ideas? Go to the beach.
Well, how can you lack inspiration if you're sitting on the beach in the south of France, you know? That's a little difficult.
Bright accents and tricky gimmicks, from teaser skirts to roll-up waistbands are in. And from Maui to Malibu, the trend is toward an athletic fit, one that a game of volleyball won't destroy. But at the same time, fit does not rule out sexiness. By no means has swimwear become conservative.
Oh, no. Oh, no! Actually, what I try and do with my swimwear is I try and infuse a kind of energy into each suit that I design. So when it's picked up at retail and tried on in the dressing room, it's comfortable, it's flattering, it fits well, it's supportive, and it's a little sexy. And I think that's what women want.
One suit from each manufacturer ends up becoming their star. The prediction this year is that Ocean Pacific's Midnight Iguana will slither away from the retail racks faster than any other.
We have an incredible suit, which is actually an idea that I got when I was in Monte Carlo, and it's called Midnight Iguana. And I think that's going to be our suit of the season.
Probably the toughest fashion decision a woman makes is selecting a new swimsuit. And this problem is not lost on the designer.
Essentially, she's wearing an article of clothing that's no more than underwear. It's really no bigger than wearing a piece of underwear, right? But she's going to be parading up and down the beaches in it. So obviously, it has to be flattering, be a little bit of sex, a little bit sexy. She doesn't want to draw too much attention, but at the same time, she wants to look good. I would say the most important thing is to feel comfortable in what she buys and to be able to move in it and not have to worry about it.
Yeah, Midnight Iguana. I think the lizard lady was my favorite. You know, when I was a small boy, Jen,
yes,
I had a lizard as a pet, and I've grown quite fond of
them. Oh, sure. By the way, Rich, that suit, Midnight Iguana, was the biggest selling suit in the history of the company, of Ocean Pacific.
Can I pick him or what?
Yeah, so there you have it. That's how it works. We give you three choices. You phone in, tell us which store you want to see, and we play it for you.
And as they say, that's not all. There's more. Here are your next three choices for our phone show.
You're in the Bahamas, baby. You've got to relax and let go.
Ah, this is the life. And if you want to play tic-tac-toe in the tropics with Tinseltown's hottest stars on Hollywood Squares, choose A. Then, he's the Wonder Man from Wheel of Fortune, but has he taken a backseat to Vanna? And can he take on Carson to become the leading man for late nights? Your choice B, Pat Sajak. And if you've always liked the thrill of high-speed driving, Track Time may be the driving school that will put you behind the wheel at 100 miles an hour. To put the pedal to the metal, choose C.
So there are your choices, and you know the number, 863-5555. Call us, and we'll be here. And I know which one I'd like to see.
You're related to somebody on the show. You can't vote. You're yourself, actually. Some of you, we found out, have been calling and trying to talk to Jen and me on the phone. We don't have time to chat with each of you. We'd love to, but just press the buttons and vote. In a moment, we'll tell you how you voted.
I want you to taste something new, Stouffer's new pizza.
Diggy, tell them it's round.
We think Stouffer's is the best tasting frozen traditional pizza.
Yeah, we think it's the best one round. Yeah. See, it's
Stouffer's has a delicious, crunchy, chewy crust.
The crust is round.
And Stouffer's new pizzas are piled high with great tasting toppings.
It's round pizza toppings.
So help yourself to Stouffer's new pizza.
Got it.
We think Stouffer's new traditional pizzas are the best tasting pizzas around.
Around pizza. Get it?
Put yourself in our place, put a smile on your face, you know that you have got taste. Come alive
at Suburban House.
Come alive,
Drexel Heritage.
Come alive
at Suburban House.
We're really thinking of ya.
It's our 27th annual winter sale at Suburban House. You'll find tremendous savings, up to 40% off home furnishings store-wide.
Come alive!
Concord and Cupertino.
Don't forget to phone in your choice. Call 863-5555.
Ladbroke Racing invites you to a winning Golden Gate holiday weekend. thrill to the thoroughbreds. Saturday and Sunday afternoons at the track or your nearby wagering satellite. Then this holiday Monday, we have a free gift for you wherever you attend the races. It's this full-sized umbrella, 100% nylon, with specially designed horse head handle, a $9.95 retail value. So don't miss the races Saturday, Sunday, and especially free umbrella day this holiday Monday at Golden Gate Fields, Bay Meadows, and the fairgrounds in Pleasanton, Santa Rosa, Monterey, and Stockton.
Capture the moment with Twining's tea. So elegant. So tasteful.
What are the best-dressed people wearing this month? Beat the backup buttons. Because if you wear this and we spot you, you could win free transit for a year. Get your buttons at participating Unocal stations. In an outfit like this, you'll definitely stop traffic.
Well, I hope you voted. Time's up, pencils down. Now we're going to look at the all-electronic board again. I keep saying that, but it is a marvel, isn't it?
Here it is. It's clearly C. C is the winner.
Stands for car, doesn't it?
That's right. You know, a lot of people apparently want to go real fast with this story, and you went really fast on the Autobahn in Germany.
Right. Recently, I went with an Evening Magazine crew to Germany where there's no speed limit on the freeway, the Autobahn, and we got a Mercedes. I personally got a Mercedes up to 162 miles an hour. Now, some of you are thinking to yourselves, I could never do that in my own car, but there is a way you can do it in this country. There is a group of people who will take you in the same car you drive to work every day, put you on a racetrack, and take you up to high speed. It's called Track Time.
Newest type of driving school in the country. You supply the car, they supply the track. It's for people with a driving ambition.
My car won't go 210, but I should be able to handle it at 130.
It's called Track Time, and what you see is what you get.
You know, a lot of people buy nice cars, fast cars, and they say, well, this is great. But they're really looking at a 55 or a 65 mile an hour speed limit, and they never really can understand what the car is all about and really how it was designed to be driven. We give them a chance to do that.
Joe Lane is one of the school's founders. Class is held at several world famous tracks. Today, it's Charlotte Motor Speedway. But before you can put the pedal to the metal, you have to
pass
put the
all
pencil
way around
to the paper.
The beginning
There's
three.
A couple of hours of classwork for these students of speed.
If you haven't driven on the banking, you're going to find out it's surprising. It's like looking through a loop.
After you check out of class, and they check out your car, it's time to hit the super slab. Every student has a personal instructor as a co-pilot. Today's guest instructor is four-time 24-hour Daytona winner, Amos Johnson.
This school differs from your normal racing school in that we're not teaching these guys to race against one another. We'll have very specific and safe rules to teach the guys how to enjoy their cars at high speed, and we will not allow any wheel-to-wheel racing.
At Track Time, they teach you to drive 7/10 your driving ability, or about 70% what you can handle. Now, this is a Ford Mustang. It'll do 145 miles per hour. 7/10 is about 100. When you drive a track like Charlotte, it gives you a better appreciation of what Richard Petty deals with every race. Right now, I'm coming out of turn two at 60 miles an hour, climbing to 70. 80, 90, 100 miles an hour of intense entertainment.
This is like a video game, except it's for real. Right now I'm doing 110 miles an hour.
Wow, 110 without getting a ticket. Okay, even though I wasn't driving a quarter of a $1 million Ferrari, it was still fun. No one ever feels the agony of defeat, and the thrill of victory is yours for the taking.
Is it really doesn't matter what type of car you drive, where you're from, what you do, who you are. Everybody's here because they enjoy cars, they enjoy driving, and they just want to have fun.
Yeah, but what I want to know is, what about the poor guy with a Hyundai? I mean, where do they take him? Probably
miniature golf course.
Probably some miniature golf course. Now, there are places around the Bay Area here where you can do the same thing.
Right.
Up at Bob Bondurant School at Sears Point and down at Laguna Seca.
So you went 162 miles, huh, Rich? I got to tell you, I have only gone fastest 80.
Jan, are you telling the truth?
I'm too chicken.
This lady hasn't gone over 80?
I'm too chicken. All right, once again, this is Evening Magazine's phone show. This is where you phone us and tell us what story you want to see.
All right, this is your last chance coming up now. Here are your third and final choices.
Twenty-five years after her death, the bittersweet memory of Marilyn Monroe still haunts photographer Joe Jasger. He claims they clicked on and off camera. To see the young Marilyn, choose A. Then, see the sand sculptor who's turned Daytona's beaches into more than 7,000 works of sandy art. And we're not talking ordinary sandcastles. To see the Sandman do his stuff, choose B. And Scott Schmidt gets his thrills skiing down vertical slopes and soaring from 80-foot jumps. But will he attempt this 8-story suicide run? Your choice C, extreme skier.
All right, I know which one I want to see. There you have your choices. Once again, people have been calling since 9 o'clock this morning, so...
And we are hearing that people are getting a busy line, so please keep trying. Well, we're going to take a quick break. You phone us, and we'll be right back.
All right, you've had your chance to vote, and you can now put down those phones. And for this evening, that's all the voting. And we understand this is very close, the one we're voting on right
okay.
now.
Okay, well, so let's check our Evening Magazine phone board.
It kept going back and forth, back and forth.
It's clearly A. A is the winner. A for Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn Monroe was the most photographed woman of her time. Her love affair with a camera was more successful than any she had with men.
Long before she was Marilyn, she was known as plain old Norma Jean. And even then, she was having an affair with the camera. And if you believe her photographer at that time, also with him.
Marilyn, 25 years after her death, the memory of this legendary screen goddess survives. But Marilyn Monroe remains a bittersweet memory for a man named Joe Jasger. Because as Marilyn was on her way to stardom, Joe was one of those forgotten by the girl he knew as Norma Jean.
In March 1946, a girl came over to me wanting to know if she'd get some photographs at no charge, if she'd have any money. And I said, don't worry, Norma Jean, I'll get you some pictures.
These pictures made up Norma Jean's first modeling portfolio and helped pave the way to her success as Marilyn Monroe. Most have never been seen before. Now, 43 years later, they're on display in Hollywood.
Everybody comes in and says, God, she looks so wholesome. She looks so fresh. It's beautiful to see these, the way she used to look.
Joe Jasger was a freelance photographer when he met 19-year-old Norma Jean Doherty. Nearly every week for several months, she posed for him on the beach and in the Hollywood Hills.
And during that time, we had a ball. She was very willing to cooperate, anything I wanted. She was a good model in that respect.
Joe claims the two clicked on and off camera. He says he was propositioned by Norma Jean, even though she was married at the time.
For some reason, she wanted to prove that I guess she's irresistible and she could seduce any man she wanted or get him to do whatever she wanted to do, but I turned her down to marriage many, many times. I am probably one of the few people, believe it or not, that never went to bed with her. I know most people did.
Just two little girls from Little Rock.
With a new look and a new name, Marilyn was on her way to screen immortality. But as she closed the door on her past as Norma Jean, Joe Jasger was one of those she shut out. Just months after Joe took his last photos of Norma Jean, he ran into her at a movie premiere.
And I says, oh, hi, Marilyn. I says, remember me? She says, no, I don't think I do. Who are you?
Goodbye, Norma Jean.
When I first knew her, she was a simple person in many, many ways. But as time went on, she became a little more complicated. a little more confused. And I don't think she knew what she wanted in life.
And while Joe's memories of Marilyn are still tinged with bitterness, he's enabled us to remember a more innocent time in Marilyn's life with his poignant images of a young Norma Jean.
I don't quite know how to say this, but this is really weird. Joe says that at that time, he took a picture of Marilyn with six toes on her left foot, and that she must have had the sixth toe removed during plastic surgery years later.
He also says that he has been offered $1 million for a photo of her foot.
Never mind what the toe is worth. I don't know.
All right, thanks for helping us program Evening Magazine's show tonight. Next Wednesday is our special Grammy preview show right before the awards at 8.
Yeah, actually, there may be a way for you to vote on what you see that night, too, because if you call 863-5555 between now and then, you will have a chance to pick your Album of the Year and Grammy-nominated Record of the Year.
And vote for your pick for Best Concept Music Video of the Year, and we'll play it for you right here in Evening Magazine's Grammy Show.
All right, here now is a brief look at some of those Grammy-nominated videos that you might vote on, beginning with the Hampton String Quartet and their classical version of, believe it or not, the classic rock and roll song, Get a Job. Selection number two is the King of Kidding, the Sultan of Send-Ups, the Prince of Parody, Al Yankovic, and I'm Fat.
Because I'm fat, fat, I'm fat.
Choice three is Storytelling Giants, a collection of videos from David Byrne and the Talking Heads.
No one was coming, she was right there, there, and she was.
Here's your chance to see the nominated video that MTV refused to air. Neil Young slams commercial endorsements and plays this note for you.
I don't sing for nobody. Makes me look like a joke. For you.
Your final choice is George Harrison's When We Was Fab.
That's it. You can vote on one of those videos beginning now all the way up until we go down on Wednesday to the Grammys,
right? That's right. We'll be seeing Michael Jackson, Tracy Chapman, all those stars file into the Shrine Auditorium.
Bobby McFerrin from the Bay Area here. Be watching us and maybe see the video you voted for. Also, coming up next week on Evening Magazine. Devil worship. Is it on the rise? And is it responsible for some of America's most violent unsolved crimes? You decide next week when we look at Satanism.
Then MDMA, or ecstasy, is the new drug of pleasure. Some claim it makes you feel warm and loving. But this doctor claims it also damages your brain.
And we'll meet the Bay Area's best, Bobby McFerrin, Santana, Robin Williams, and more, who've been nominated for the music industry's highest honor, the Grammy. Thanks for using your phones to help make it fun for us. We've enjoyed it. Thank you and good night.
Have a great weekend, everybody. See you on Monday. Good night.